Now let's talk about the degrees of freedom or DOF. It is also called the mobility of a mechanism. DOF is defined as the number of independent parameters required to specify the location of every link within a mechanism. So, for example, if you take a coordinate plane XY and I have a line which is lying in this plane. Alright, so if I have to specify the position of this line, I would need to specify the distances from the two axes. This is X and this is Y. And I would also need to specify the angle theta. So I need three parameters minimum to specify the location of this line in this coordinate plane. Okay, so this is a very simple thing. You can generalize it and you can say that in a 2D plane, for a link, you have a minimum of 3 degrees of freedom. Alright, now there are two criterions mathematically. The first one is the Kurzbach equation. According to the Kurzbach equation, the degree of freedom, capital F, can be calculated as 3 into capital N minus 1, okay, minus 2P1, minus P2. So, capital F is the degree of freedom, N is the number of links, P1 is the number of lower pairs with 1 degree of freedom, and P2 is the number of higher pairs with 2 degree of freedom. Okay, so I would say that capital F is the degree of freedom of the mechanism, capital N is the number of links, capital P1 is the number of lower pairs, with 1 degree of freedom, and P2 is the number of higher pairs with 2 degree of freedom. Okay, so this is how we find out the DOF with the help of a Kurzbach equation. Okay, now if your degree of freedom is greater than or equal to 1, then such a thing would give you a mechanism which can actually function like a mechanism. Okay, if your degrees of freedom is equal to 0, then such an arrangement of links is no longer a mechanism, rather it becomes a statically determinate structure. Statically determinate structure. Okay, and if your degrees of freedom is less than minus 1, then this becomes statically indeterminate structure. Statically indeterminate structure. So this needs to be remembered. Okay, now if I make F equal to 1 over here, then the criteria that we get is called the Grubler's criteria. So for capital F equal to 1, if I put in the Kurzbach equation, I get the Grubler's criteria. Okay, and that is 1 is equal to 3n minus 3 minus 2p1 minus p2. Bring all on the left hand side, so you will get 2p1 plus p2 minus 3n plus 4 equal to 0. This is what you call the Grubler's criteria. Okay, so make a note of this. That is, you put F is equal to 1 into this and you get in return a Grubler's criteria equation. Right, so this is how we understand the degrees of freedom. Now let's move on to the next topic and talk about the Grashof's condition.